You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at borisfx.com.
So if I wanted to track this bird's feet, I'd still use my mesh generation. And I'd probably only use shear and mesh. And we can let Mocha track this. But what you're going to see is that while Mocha will respect that bend in the leg, once we start to get a whole lot of blur, we've got a problem. So how do we fix that? Well, we can take our mesh selection tool, select our mesh, and try to align our mesh again to where our foot is going to be. It's not an ideal solution, but it's a solution. And then we continue to track. And we go back to our original keyframe and we continue tracking. Once our track is complete, we can turn off our mesh again. And we can start to correct our roto, just like we did for the pigeon body. And you can see where it gets really blurry, we start to run into problems, but that's okay. We're just going to correct our roto. It'll still save us time because we're still getting some of that motion for free. Now, of course, this becomes a mess, so we're going to find our next good frame and we're going to correct our roto to the good frame, not to the very bad frame. And we'll sort of worry about animating between this extreme warp in this section. And then we're not going to worry about it as far as accuracy goes because it's a huge blurry mess. So we're just going to kind of correct what we can. And we're going to try to grab this motion as a tween keyframe. So I can see that there's the back of our little foot there. The leg goes up here. We've got these points that kind of blur together. And I think what I'll do is I'll add some motion blur in Mocha based on the track to really blur this where it needs blurring when I apply the data inside of After Effects. And again, we're just going to pick this up here, grab some of that blur. And you can see because of how much the shape is changing, there's no way PowerMesh is going to grab that. There's no data there anymore. It's just blur. So when you run into areas like that, of course, you're going to have to hand animate to get past it. But once you're past it, it's a matter of extremely minor corrections to finish your shot out. Now, you can still use edge snapping and all that kind of stuff when you're doing this, but I would not for an object that is this close to the background color. Now, the nice thing about this is you can see we got all of this pigeon leg for basically free. So the back leg more or less rotated itself because of PowerMesh. And the front leg, all we had to do was get past that rough blur section with some hand animation. And we end up with something that's pretty nice. Let's turn our mats on. And let's look at this pigeon roto. That is the power of PowerMesh roto. Now remember how I said I was going to add motion blur to this? I'm going to select my foot, add motion blur, back foot, motion blur, and pigeon roto, motion blur. And so now, let's look for our blur area right here. And let's go ahead and turn our mat. Let's look at our mat for the front foot. And you can see that we've got all of that nice motion blur for free on the front foot. So we're going to save this. Let's check our back foot, front foot, and the pigeon itself. So now we're going to just go back to our selected layer. We're going to save and close Mocha. I'm going to go to my mat. I'm going to say apply mat. I'm going to add like a feather of like 5 pixels. And now there's our pigeon. So now if we wanted to do like a color correct or a levels, we could color correct our pigeon. We could add some hue and saturation, saturate the heck out of our pigeon to a ridiculous level. And now there's our motion blurred roto using PowerMesh and rotoscoping this entire bird from tracking to finish. Took about 20 minutes. And that automatically calculated motion blur is just beautiful. In this lesson, we covered what happens when you can't track certain pixels with PowerMesh, dealing with extreme blur, and adding realism with motion blur. Next up, we're going to talk about PowerMesh workflows.
You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects, and footage, purchase the premium version, available at borisfx.com.